Hey, hi, I'm Ron Lau, and I run TLCTugger.com, which is a company that supplies devices for men to restore their foreskins. Now, I started doing that about 5 years ago, but just last June, I was able to actually quit my day job because there are so many people who need our help. I didn't have enough hours in the day to help them all and still be a good engineer. So now this is it. This is my racket. It's my life's work. And it makes me the luckiest person in the world, really, because I think every person really needs to search the world and find a way to make it better, leave it a better place than they found it. And it's the American dream to find a way to provide a service that people need. And in my case, it's something that I know helps people. And in so many cases, it's something they'd never heard of before, you know, my contact with them or before they discovered me. And to know that I'm bringing something to people that they didn't even know they were looking for, and now they found it and they're thrilled. It's just the most rewarding feeling. And to be able to pursue something I'm passionate about and have it support my family, as it now seems like it might be able to do, it makes me very lucky. I've come to Washington this week because it's Genital Integrity Awareness Week. And what Intactivists like to do is mark the anniversaries of the law in the U.S. that was passed to protect girls from genital cutting. Notice I said girls only. In fact, boys are specifically excluded from that law, and I don't think it says anything about intersex people either. So what we need is a new law that treats everybody fairly, protects boys too, and also intersex people, I think, is something that's way under thought about in the United States. People don't appreciate that there are intersex people who, to the last one, if you ask them when they're adults, most of them would say, whatever normalizing surgery they did to me on as a child, I don't even know what it was because there are bad records about it. I sure wish they hadn't done it. I'd like to know what my genitals might have felt like for me if they would have been left alone. And every boy deserves that same right to know what natural sexual experience is supposed to feel like. And I just get so disgusted to think that it's still tolerated in this country. You know, you can't cut a girl, you can't even take a drop of blood in a ceremonial fashion if it's part of your culture. That's prohibited by the law, but if you want to cut your boy, you can throw a party. How on earth that's allowed? I mean, if I got a new puppy and I wanted to throw a party and have everybody come watch my puppy get circumcised, I'd be hauled off to the loony bin or to the jail or something. But here we are in the United States, 2009, still cutting infants. It just boggles my mind. Today at the Capitol, I had a lot of opportunities to talk to people who had never heard of foreskin restoration. They couldn't even imagine why you'd want to do that. It sounds insane to the typical uninitiated person. But I remember in this one case, these group of young men, they looked about college-aged. By the time we got done explaining to them that with this regrown foreskin, they can not only have a glands that's protected from drying and abrasion and becomes supple and more sensitive and shiny, but they'd also experience this luxurious sort of a rolling, gliding action. They were, the one guy was kind of looking depressed. The one I was speaking most close up to seemed to be very looking forward to starting up with this. So it's just so exciting to reach people and to know that once they get a dose of what restoration can do for them, they're going to become the next vocal intactivist out there on that wall someday, you know, shouting down the chorus of genital mutilators. The people we reach, they're responsive. The parts that really get me going are when we reach people in the media, like Mr. Howard Stern, the world's loudest pro-intact celebrity. He, what a great guy, and he's very much on board with infants' rights. What he doesn't seem to understand is how much restoring can do for you. So I was so lucky this last August, I got a chance to go to his studio and show him my own foreskin restoration result. And he was telling his cast of loonies in the studio there, well, there you go, guys. Look, this man is giving himself back a foreskin. How about that? And that was probably the thrill of my life so far, honestly. So to know that a guy like that now knows about restoring, and then the next time it comes up on his show, when somebody's complaining about being cut, because he always asks his guests, are you cut or anything? He's likely to say something like, well, I heard about this restoring thing, maybe you should try that. To know that that could happen any day because of what I was able to do to him, that gives me a real thrill. So it's gonna come in little waves. We get somebody like Howard Stern on board, next we just gotta work on, you know, Oprah, David Letterman, Andy Rooney, We'll get there. I'd really be honored if you check out my website. It's TLCTugger.com. And when you go there, you'll see that we have these products to help you restore, and also a user group where you can see other users' progress and ask questions from people who aren't selling anything. And we also have, for people who need some help affording these devices, we have an annual song contest. And just by submitting something that's related to circumcision, like a song parody or a poem or a YouTube video, you can earn credit toward your restoration device. And it really gives me a thrill to see what people come up with and to know that I'm helping people afford to pursue this, because it's so important to me.
Great. Thanks so much, Ron. I really appreciate you taking the time.
Cheers.